Hello children, today I am going to teach you geography of class 7 and the first chapter is our environment. Children, we all are familiar with this word environment and we often use this word. Children, what is environment? What do you understand by this term environment? Children, you look around you, what are the things you will able to see? Children, you will able to see plants, animals, sunlight, water, road, building, transports, etc. Children, identify those things which is automatically present in our environment, in our nature. Plants, tree, river, land, these things are automatically present in our environment. And come to the another one, things which is made by human things. Building, school, college, road, hospitals, transports, these things made by human, so that's why that is called human environment. Children, all the things which is made by nature is called natural environment, and all the things which is made by human beings is called human environment. That means in our environment two types of things are found. First is natural environment and the second one is human made environment. And children, you know that in geography we study about many components of natural environment and the human environment. And in geography we also study about the interrelation of human environment and the natural environment. How human environment depend on the natural environment and how natural environment helps to human environment. We discuss all these things in geography. Children, first come to the word environment. The term environment refers to all the external condition in which an organism lives, and it comes from the French word environnement. Environment comes from the French word environnement, which means surround, and that is about the environment. And children, you know, on the basis of origin, geographical elements is classified into two groups. First, natural elements and human-made elements. Then you will see me what is natural elements and what is human-made elements. Children, all the things which is created by nature is considered as is the part of natural elements, and all the natural elements considered as natural environment. Clear? And all the things which is created by human, they are considered as human made elements, and they also comes under the human made environment. Okay children, these both environment, human environment and natural environment, interdependent to each other, I already told you. And human beings use their natural resource to fulfill their needs, and with the course of time human demand and the needs has changed, so their way to use the natural resource is also changed. In early time, people had less demand, so that's why they used their natural resource in limited way. But now our economical growth is totally depend on natural environment. For every work, human beings interact to their natural environment to develop their economical growth. Just take an example. We are making furniture and chair and etc. with the wood, right? But from where we get wood? We get wood from the tree and plant. That means human beings use tree and plant and convert tree and plant into the furniture and chairs. Okay, that means human beings interact with their natural resource, they modify it and they convert it into the more valuable things to develop their economical status. And children, human environment and natural environment change due to the two process. Sometimes natural environment and human environment change due to natural process, and sometimes it changes due to human activity. Now you will see me how natural environment and human environment change due to natural process and human activity. Children, take example. Earlier, most of the land is a example of natural components, right? And earlier most of the land was covered by the forest. But with the course of time, with the passage of time, human beings used most of the land for agricultural purpose, for making industry, for making building, etc. And also present day our climatic condition is also changing due to the human activity and the natural process. And also every day some species of plants and animal extinct and new species evolve. They are just because of natural process and human activity. Children, now come to the natural environment. Now we will discuss in detail about the natural environment and the human environment. Children, first tell me, what are the things come under the natural environment? Plants, animals, mountain, river, air, water. Children, in natural environment, components are classified into two groups, biotic components and the abiotic components. You all know about biotic component and the abiotic components. First come to the biotic components. We know that all the living things come under the biotic component, just like plant, animal, which have life. They are considered as biotic component. And all the things just like air, water, land, soil, they comes under the abiotic component because they have not life. Come to the children, here we will discuss in detail about land, water, air, etc. Children, you know that our earth is divided into four major domains. We already discussed it in the last class. First, lithosphere. Second, hydrosphere. Third is atmosphere, and the fourth is biosphere. Children, come to the first. What is lithosphere? Lithosphere, all the domains of the earth is very important. Children, come to the lithosphere. All land, we know that earth crust is divided into two group, that is land and water, and both land and water come under the lithosphere. Children, what is lithosphere? The term lithosphere means rocky crust. That, and we also know that earth is divided into three group. First, crust, mantle and core. Earth interior is divided into three groups, that is crust, mantle and core. And the lithosphere is the uppermost part of the crust. The crust and the uppermost part of the mantle considered as lithosphere. Here I have drawn that earth interior has divided into three part: crust, mantle and core. And the lithosphere considered as the crust and the upper part of the mantle. That means these part is come under the lithosphere, crust and the upper part of mantle. And it is made by rocks, so that's why it is also called rockysphere. And the average thickness of lithosphere is 100 kilometer. The average thickness of lithosphere is about 100 kilometer. It is made up of rock and minerals. And lithosphere made up of rock and minerals. Children, again, this lithosphere divided into two group. First, oceanic crust and the continental crust. Oceanic crust and the continental crust. Because on the crust, two type of bodies are found: land bodies and the water bodies. Land bodies are considered under the continental crust and the water bodies considered under the oceanic crust. And this lithosphere is very important to us because our all the activity, we use land for doing agriculture, for making industry and settlement, etc. So lithosphere is very important to us. All the living beings live on the land. Then come to the hydrosphere. Children, hydrosphere considered all the water bodies of the earth, like ocean, sea, bays, lakes and river, etc. And underground water also come under the hydrosphere. That means all the water bodies come under the hydrosphere. And we know that water is also very essential for all living beings. And on the earth, water is found in three states: solid, liquid and gas. Solid, that means in the ice form; liquid, in the which we drink water; and the gaseous form, that is water vapor. Children, that is about the hydrosphere. Then come to the atmosphere. Children, we know that the envelope of air which surrounds the earth is called atmosphere. and atmosphere is mixture of different gases, and most important and life-giving gas is found in atmosphere, that is oxygen. All human beings take oxygen and release carbon dioxide. And we know that atmosphere also protect us from the harmful radiation of sun, that is ultraviolet rays. And atmosphere is also very important for all living beings and we already discussed about the detail of atmosphere. Then come to the biosphere. Children, now tell me, what is biosphere? Children, the narrow zone of lithosphere, hydrosphere and atmosphere. The narrow zone of atmosphere, lithosphere and hydrosphere make new zone, that is called biosphere, and life is only possible in the biosphere. And children, come to the biosphere. This sphere support life, and it is thus called the living world. And biosphere is also called living world. Biosphere consists of the plant and animals kingdom. And biosphere consists all the plants and the animal kingdom. Biosphere, in a biosphere is a small compared to all three domains of the earth, but it is very important to sphere, and it is a small but 15 lakh species are found in biosphere. And ecosystem is part of the biosphere. Then you will see me, what is ecosystem? Children, in ecosystem all the living beings interact with their physical environment, and in the ecosystem all living beings are interdependent to each other. And sometimes, children, then come to the next, human environment. Children, as I told you that natural human environment is totally based on natural environment. Human beings interact with their nature. But in present time, human beings are using their natural resource in very large amount, and which create many problems in our environment. Human beings use natural environment to make comfortable their life. And in the early time, people had limited to needs, so the relation of human and the nature was good. But nowadays human becomes so greedy, they using their natural resource in careless manner, and they exploit more and more resources. Children, so that's why, just because of these, human natural resource facing many problems present day. Children, after the globalization, industrialization and overpopulation, demand of the people increased, and to fulfill all the demands, people used natural resource in large quantity. So that create many problems in our environment. And just because of over exploitation of resources, our environment facing many problems. And come to the environmental pollution. We know that present day all the component of nature is become polluted. Air, water, land and many other things, just because of human activity. Children, if we will use natural resource in large quantity and in careless manner, then natural resource become extinct on the earth, and that time we will not able to survive on the earth because human beings is totally depend on natural resource. So first we should have to be aware about our natural resources, then only we can able to develop ourselves, we can able to save earth. Thank you.